Sit you down, John.
Mrs. Allen, I don't know how Mr. Dickinson has presented this to you.
You boasted you could save Mrs. Allen money. You will either support that statement or apologize.
I think we ought to get one thing straight, sir. I didn't boast. Now, you came to me with a challenge, and it was at your suggestion that this meeting was called.
Now, let's quibble, Tony. If you have something to say, please say it.
You're absolutely right. Let's get down to business. Now then, Mrs. Allen, what I'm going to say to you may sound devious, but believe me, it isn't. It's perfectly legal and above board. You're a Pennsylvania resident. If you own stock in a corporation which does not do business in this state, you have to pay a county personal property tax. If you own stock in a corporation which does business in this state and which pays taxes here, that stock is not subject to the same tax. Mrs. Allen, you own $50 million worth of stock in the Allen Oil Company, which is exclusively a New Jersey corporation. And as a result, you pay $200,000 a year taxes on that stock.
You're telling us something we're well aware of. She has to pay. That's the law.
Yes, I do. The county assessor is a very pleasant man, but he won't let me get away with anything.
Well, why don't we arrange it differently?
What are you getting at?
Simply this. Mrs. Allen also owns or controls several Pennsylvania corporations. It would be a very simple matter to transfer some of the activities of the Allen Oil Company so that they can take over operation of any one of these Pennsylvania concerns. As a result, the Allen Oil Company would be doing business in Pennsylvania. The corporate taxes would come out of the same pans, but different pockets. Mrs. Allen personally would save $200,000 a year.
Gilbert?
My dear Mrs. Allen, this is a wild and reckless idea. What's more, it's interference in company policy. Why, you wouldn't dream of using your voting powers to force the officers to do such a crazy juggling act.
Oh, wouldn't I? Of course, I don't quite understand it all. Do you, Joan?
Yes, I do. Mr. Lawrence is using Pennsylvania taxes on corporations to knock out your county personal property tax.
Oh, I see.
Mrs. Allen, we've always devoted our best efforts to your interests.
Nobody disputes that, Gilbert.
You don't have to patronize me, John. When the time comes that a cub lawyer and my own daughter tell me I'm deficient in my duties.
I didn't say that, Father. You're a good lawyer. Everybody knows that. It's just that you're not a tax specialist. And it's obvious Tony has become one.
Well, what about that, Gilbert?
Mrs. Allen, we'll turn over your affairs to anyone you care to name.